I don't think you understand. I'm obsessed. Okay, so let's go ahead and let's get right into this get ready with me. I feel like it's been a long time since I've filmed and get ready with me without like talking about something crazy. This one is going to be more so a tutorial. This is my summer routine. A lot of this stuff is a bit similar, but it's a little bit different because I have gotten tanner, and I'm gonna show you how I do it now that I'm a little bit darker, and as the season goes on, I'm gonna get darker and darker, which I am not ashamed of because that just means that we outside, vaccinated of course. So I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna start my brows. I've showed you all how I did my brows all the time. So I'm gonna go ahead and fill them in, and then I'm gonna show you when I do my little carve out technique, the updated version of that. Okay, so now that I have this done, I'm just gonna make sure I spoolie that out. I always end up having to fix it after I do my full makeup. So I just kind of do this to get the shape of it down, and then I kind of like fill it in some more. I'm growing my brows out, trying to wait until it gets closer to my birthday to get them done, just so they could be like super, super thick. Get them what I'm seeing? So today I think I'm gonna do a light brown like eyeshadow. So we're gonna do some concealer. We're gonna use Warm Honey. If you do not, these two are some drugstore concealer options that I like. So you have the LA Girl Pro Concealer, and then I also like the Ruby Kisses HD one. So these two are really good drugstore ones, but I'm about to go on with the Ruby Kiss one. This is the shade Warm Honey, and I just put it on the back of my hand. And I wanna go for a very like soft glam, but very glam, because I have some content I need to shoot today for my website, which I'm super excited. It will be launching on the 13th, because the 14th through the, I think it's the 17th, the 18th, the 14th through the 18th, I will be celebrating the second year anniversary of Deja's Daily Dose. So I've been really prepping, working on the site, getting the content and everything together, as well as the podcast that the site will be having, which is called Let Me Tell You Something. So make sure you all are following the Deja's Daily Dose Instagram page, Twitter, as well as our TikTok to stay updated on all things Deja's Daily Dose. Stay on the lookout for that, because that is what I've been working on. I have some Deja chats. I have one on Monday the 14th, and then I have one on Tuesday the 15th. The blog second year anniversary is the 17th. I like to do a lighter concealer at the bottom of here, and I don't put it at the top, which I think I've showed you all or told you all once before, but I don't put it at the top because it makes your brows look very 3D. So you use your foundation shade at the top. So once I put that on, I'm going to take my sponge. This is the e.l.f. sponge, and I'm just going to pat that in right up here. Oh, and to prime and stuff, prime my face up, I just use the Mario Badescu facial mish. I think I have the purple one. This is what I use to prime and prep my face. For my foundation, I'm going to use this Delilah Robinson Cosmetics. I'm going to show you all it. And I am in the shade Coffee, which is 108. I'm going to go ahead and put that on the back of my hand and carve that out. But I'm just going to do the top of my brows first. Okay, so now that that's on, I'm gonna kind of like, you know, blend that out just a little bit. I'm going to go in with my LA Pro Girl Concealer. My foundation's running, that's why I kind of was holding my hand a little crazy. And I'm just gonna take a brush and take this brown shade right here and just kind of rub that all over my eyes. And of course you could touch that stuff up more later, like if I want to add some more eyeshadow on, I could do so. But right now I'm going to go in. You could take that same brush that you used with the concealer and foundation earlier, but I'm just going to take a different one. And I'm going to take that same concealer shade, and I'm going to go back in with the lighter concealer, but first I'm going to go in with that shade Warm Honey and put that all on my highlighted spots. Oh, well, almost forgot about primer. I'm going to put some primer on. This is the e.l.f. Putty Primer. I really like this primer, like, a lot, actually. I'm putting it, like, in all the areas that crease a lot. So, under my eyes, make sure you rub your face upwards. I don't really, like, put it all over my face. It's not really necessary. I just put it on a lot of the areas where my makeup typically creases at. So it creases a lot in this nose area and under my eyes for the most part. And now I'm gonna go in with that shade Warm Honey and put that on all of my highlighted spots. And then after that, I'm going to put my blush on my blush areas. And this is the e.l.f. Putty Primer. It doesn't have the shade name on it, but this is that dark pink one. I'm doing black hair today. I haven't done black hair in a minute, so I haven't really been putting on much blush. And then if I was putting on blush, I was putting on a lighter shade, but I'm gonna go in with this really berry shade and use like a little brush like this and blend it out with my sponge. So I'm gonna kind of speed this part up, but you all will see what I'm doing. Now that we're looking a little crazy, I'm trying to hurry up because my daggone foundation is starting to drip. So I'm gonna do like one more pump of, I'm gonna do a half a pump just to make sure we have enough. And I'm going to take this e.l.f. brush. This is the e.l.f. Putty Primer application brush, but I like to use it for foundation. And I'm going to apply this all of the areas where I didn't really focus that concealer and everything else on. So, like, all the rest of my face. And this helps you use less product. So, see, I don't even have to take it all up there over my eyes. I'm just kind of doing it right here. And, of course, you kind of blend it in. And you can see the blush is underneath the foundation. Nice and glowing. And I'm dragging that down to my neck. And I like a really, really bright under eye. So you could leave it right here if you want to, but I'm gonna go in with a lighter shade, mix it in with this shade I already used just to get that really cute pop under eye, because I really like pop under eye. I'm going to take the shade medium beige in that same Ruby Kisses HD primer, put it beside the little bit of concealer I already have. I don't need too much of this because we don't want to go super crazy. And before I put it on, I'm going to just get my powder ready because I like to go in with this immediately after. This is the Wet n Wild Photo Finish Powder in the shade Banana. And now that that's done, I'm gonna go directly in with my setting powder and set my whole entire highlighted areas. Now I'm going to take a contouring powder brush, which is just this rounder brush, and my contour palette, which I like to use this True Complex contour palette, and I use the shade this medium one for sculpt. And I'm just going to do the number 3. Kim K taught me that. I'm going to go ahead and carve out my face. I like to go under here, right here in this cheekbone area, and up on my forehead. And I don't do a crazy contour. This is actually considered the bronze color in the palette. The contour will be this darker one. I don't typically use that. If anything, I might use it for eyeshadow here and there, but I just go in with that middle shade. And I'm just carving out my face. And then for a nose contour, I just kind of take the brush and go like this. So I don't do like a whole nose contour thing. I think it's super pretty though. But for my everyday like summer look, for like a regular look for me, I just go in a little bit. But my favorite thing to do to really get my face on and popping is to take that setting powder after I do my contour, put it on here, and chisel that cheek. And then you could just kind of like darken your contour as much as you want or as much as you need to, and just play around with everything. Add some more setting powder, add some more contour, depending, you know, just kind of do it up to how much you want to shape your face up to. And I'm going to go back in really quick with that brush and that brown eyeshadow and just kind of touch it up a little bit, bring it back down. Because when you do your concealer and everything, I like to really make sure I'm up under the eyes. So I tend to just cover up a little bit of the eyeshadow. Now I'm going to take this big fluffy brush and brush away all of the powder. And then set my face with some of that Mario Badescu setting spray. Just to kind of like get it together so we can do our little details that really make it pop, like the lashes, liner, etc. You can still kind of see a little bit of that berry blush. So if you want to kind of keep it like that, you can. But we are going to add a powder blush back on top. And once we set our face, you see how we got all the powder off. And it's still just a little bit, like, you know, you can see some of this little lines right here. I'm going to go back in with that contour brush and kind of like clean that up just a little bit more. Before, like, while this is still drying down, I'm going to go ahead in with my like lashes. Well, I'm not gonna put I'm gonna put the lash glue on, but I'm going to do like my liner and mascara and everything and put the lash glue on my lashes real quick. So I'm going to like do a little time lapse. The setting spray is still kind of setting down in my face, but I'm going to start working on the eyes. So now I have my lashes and mascara and everything on. I'm going to now take a blush before I go back in with my final setting spray and everything. For blush, I'm going to go into my Box of Crown palette. I love to use this shade as a blush. This shade magenta right here is just the perfect little berry, and it has like some little bit of, it's like a shimmer, but I don't really see too much shimmer. I'm just going to take this and just put it right up in here. There's a little bit of shine you can see on my cheek and stuff, but that's not a problem because I don't really use highlight like that anymore. So I think it's super cute. And you can always just take a little brush like this, kind of dim it down a little bit. Now that I have that on, I'm pretty much done with the face. I'm going to go in and do my lips now. I'm going to take a dark brown liner. I typically can use my eyebrow pencil, but I have a dark brown liner. But that's not sharpest, so I'm gonna use my eyebrow pencil and carve out my lips. You all know I love to use that shade By NYX, is called Cario. And a shade that looks just like it that I've been using is this Velvet Lippy. This is in the shade Toasted, and this is the Absolute New York one. Love this nude. And I'm gonna set my face one more time with my Urban Decay All Nighter Spray. And while the lip is drying and everything like that, I'm gonna go ahead and do my wig and stuff, and I'll be back with the gloss and everything like that to close out the look. So I just put on this little hair flip wig. I'm about to take some photos and stuff for IG. But for the gloss, we're gonna use this pinky nude. This is the, honestly, I'm not sure. It looks like this. I got it from the beauty supply store, and it's in the shade Kimberly. Yeah, I wear this so much. The name ain't even on it no more. But it's this really pretty pink shade. Like, look at that. Look at that. Ah, I don't think you understand. I'm obsessed. Like, just so cute. I hope you all enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you give it a big thumbs up. I'll see you all in the next one. Bye, guys.